Hello there, lovely people. It's Alex from Nintendo Life here, and what's this? A video I alluded to and I'm actually doing relatively on time? Perish the thought. Yes, today we are looking at this. Doesn't look like much, does it? But this GameCube has been modified to produce a totally biscuits HDMI digital signal. No ugly converters, no awkward cables, no CRT screens. This is the genuine digital signal that the GameCube produces, harnessed and pumped out like so much delicious butter. The port on the back of the unit is a little bit messy, as you can see, but we've been assured that this is an early unit and future efforts will be a lot cleaner. But what's the point of all this, I hear you cry? Why don't I just use the composite input on my TV? Well, if it's an HD TV, I will tell you why, you strange home-invading ragamuffin. HD TVs often do have composite or SCART input, but they don't display the analog signal natively. It has to be converted. Think of it like having one of these cheap AV to HDMI converters inside your telly. These produce input lag, oversaturated color, they don't treat aspect ratios with respect, and overall make for a noticeably anti-biscuits experience. Also, if you happen to live in the PAL region like my good self, then this sucker will be able to de-interlace that horrible 480i signal into something a lot more palatable. PAL GameCube games do not support 480p resolutions, despite the fact that the console is perfectly capable of doing so. I suppose you could say that Nintendo didn't believe that the PAL region was very progressive. But how does this thing actually look? Well, once we get the all clear from the mighty Mega Yarn Yoshi of Judgment, we can find out.
Rogue Squadron, how can we help?
Stop that cannon fire!
We'll do what we can.
These games are all from the PAL region, so everything that you're seeing are interlaced signals that have been de-interlaced with the mod with zero lag, and also have their resolutions increased to 720p so the signal is compatible with more modern screens. Remember, this is all running on original hardware, so the mod can't render the game in a higher resolution. It simply allows for the cleanest picture possible. I don't think I need to say it, but I will anyway. This mod makes every game look gorgeous. Well, almost every game. If you want more options for things like scan lines for a more retro feel, or you want to stop the resolution popping up every time it changes, spoilers, it happens a lot, you can access the mod's menu by holding down the L, R, X, and Y buttons. I don't understand the whole scan line thing personally. I thought the whole point was to make games look as clean as possible, but whatever floats your boat. The image quality as a whole is simply wonderful. Colors pop, edges are sharp, and generally everything looks swanky. The same goes for audio. Everything's rich, deep, characterful, clear, and there's a really good amount of range. That being said, because we're using a de-interlaced image, there are a few instances of sawtooth edges and flicker, but these are generally only really noticeable on menus and won't appear on games outputting a progressive signal. Lucky Yanks. The biggest advantage of this mod, aside from the really, really good-looking games and simply just working on HD screens, is the fact that there is virtually zero input lag. Suddenly, games are as responsive as you need them to be. Tight platforming and this wave-dashing thing I've heard of are now viable on screens with less depth than the Silmarillion. All in all, if you want to get the best quality picture and audio from your GameCube with the least amount of hassle, I can't think of anything more appropriate than this mod. There are a few rough edges here and there with the whole interlace signal, but it still looks so much better than if you weren't to deinterlace it at all. If you want to get your hands on one of these or just find out more about it, then check that link in the description, simple as. Thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, then why don't you convert that subscribe button in any way you see fit, and be sure to check out NintendoLife.com for all sorts of lovely Nintendo-related content. Thank you again for watching. Bye-bye. I think I'm done. Biscuits gravy! Ba 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 ba. Cut, young man, cut to another forward place. Ba 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 ba. Didn't believe that the PAL region was very progressive. Come on, use your imaginations, people. I don't have a CRT anymore.